you understand?
Hey, everybody. I'm Tony Jones, and welcome to the Tony Jones Show.
Is this not enough? People are willing to take the risk. Is this sort of a herd mentality, a lemming-like mentality? If you don't go with the flow, you're anti-American and therefore a suspect.
The Tony Jones Show, featuring punk, rockabilly, psychobilly, and Providence, Rhode Island's finest, starts right now.
He's a dangerous militia member, I hear.
Oh, and there she blows.
Friends, the time for mediocrity and broadcasting is over. My name is Tony Jones, and you are tuned in to The Tony Jones Show, your destination for talk and rock. Online at TonyJones.org, Facebook.com/TonyJonesShow, on the almighty Twitter at TonyJonesNRI, kicking off this week's program with some Weld Square. A Belladonna Killed My Rose, the name of that one. Thank you for tuning in and hanging out with me. The new music is coming in here to headquarters fast and furious, so we're going to get to a bit of that. Plus, We're going to get to a bit of music from the gig that I got to play last night in Newport, Rhode Island. I want to talk a bit about that. And I know that it would take 11 cans of Red Bull to kill me. And I want to tell you why I know that and loop you into this information. So we're going to be talking about Caffeine Informer between now and the top of the hour. But before that, I want to do get right back into the music. Just came through the studio here. We're going to have a double shot, and we're going to hear two from Five of the Eyes. Starting off with Mirrors, you heard it here on The Tony Jones Show.
Walked out in the moonlight, crazed, unable to fight. And you stayed behind and stayed up late. You left the lights on as a vigil in the night. You woke me up to burn me down, the only time I feel alive. Is in the heat, reaction creeps, I want to burn this city down. Your smile is full of pain that I have caused, but not all is lost. Broken pieces, mirror daydreams, cut my fingers, trying to put them back together. Back up.
Coming out of 2 from 5 of the eyes, I believe in traditional media, that would be what's known as a double shot right here on the Tony Jones Show. TonyJones.org, Facebook.com/TonyJonesShow. I'm on Twitter at TonyJonesNRI. Do remember that I do monitor the social media accounts throughout the program. As always, I'd love to hear from you. If you're in a band, you can go to TonyJones.org. You can go to rifreeradio.org, click on that contact page. As I mentioned at the top of the hour, new music coming in here, Fast and Furious. You can find Five of the Eyes, facebook.com/Five of the Eyes. They are from Portland, Maine, so that I would put in the local music category. They have a few shows coming up. They're going to be in Lowell, Mass at Uncharted. They're going to be at Hamden, at the Space in Hamden, Connecticut, and a disturbing trend that I'm seeing from more and more of these great bands is that I do not see a Providence date on that agenda. So I know countless promoters and music folk listen to this show, so we should try to remedy that. Now, speaking of shows, last night, and shame on me because it is 20, 25 minutes from my house, I went to Jimmy's Saloon for the first time. Tony Jones and the Cretan Three played with DNA's Evolution, The Safes, and the Nymphadels, and DJ Psycho Eddie. I got to say, great room down in Newport, what I would consider to be just a great, just classic rock and roll type establishment. I had a blast. Have you ever been to Jimmy's?
I can honestly say no. I have not been to Jimmy's.
Bit trepidatious because it got to about midnight, 12:01, and I decided I'm going to dine. I'm going to eat. So the food was great. I couldn't believe it.
You see, that seems to be a trend that's going on with a lot of bars. They're getting their way out of the friolated arts, and they're actually making food that's, I'm not going to use the word good for you, but I am going to say
definitely not
it
good for you.
Tastes better than it probably should.
Yeah, no, this was delicious, and there was a time, especially here locally and with bars in general, where you just did not eat bar food. Because you would die.
Well, you see, that was a big caveat for me for going out after any show, because you don't eat at the bar. Just because they have a fryer later does not mean they know how to make French fries. It just means they know how hot grease works and throw something in there to try to satiate that hunger you have going on and probably get some more of your money undeservedly.
Right. And wasn't there, I mean, far from this being a business show by any stretch of the imagination, but wasn't there at some point something to do with an entertainment license or a liquor license here in Rhode Island where you had to have some kind of food And that's why you see bars that serve chips or just something basic.
It's still part of licensing. Part of almost every liquor license you're going to get in the state of Rhode Island, there has to be some sort of soak it up clause. I think I'm making
sell a loaf of bread from behind the bar.
Well, there are some bars that take this to an extreme because they don't want to serve you food.
Yeah.
So you could get a grilled cheese for like $10, or you can get a can of soup microwaved,
yep,
lovingly microwaved for you, for like $9.
I know there's one down in we'll keep nameless, but there's one down in South County where you can buy sardines and smelts from behind the bar, and that's simply because they don't want to serve food and they know nobody's buying smelts at midnight. Or maybe they are. I don't know, but I know I'm not.
Well, if they're really good smelts, I mean, I'd give them a try. But
the only reason I know what a smelt is from watching SpongeBob SquarePants. So we're going to get back to the music now. We're going to have a Jimmy Saloon block here, featuring some of the bands I had the honor of sharing the stage with last night. Another weird thing about the show last night, Eddie, is that, and I was talking about this with my bass player, George Garner, there was four bands that played, and only two of the four bands had bass players. It's either a dying art or there's no non-flaky bass players out there. But you know the Nymphadels, of course, a two-piece.
Yep.
And this next band, DNA's Evolution, they were also a two-piece. So lacking bass players, I guess, is the next thing we'll be talking about here. DNA's Evolution up next, a double shot from them on The Tony Jones Show.
Yeah. bared his teeth, but only his hand pierced through. I see our Petra, well, she's a predator too. She looked into his eyes. We'll be right back.
Coming out of a double-double right here on the Tony Jones Show, two from DNA's Evolution, Petra and the Wolf and the Heist. Then after that, two from the safes. We kicked that off with Hot Pursuit KO, the one you just heard. Tony Jones here. You were tuned into the Tony Jones Show. TonyJones.org, Facebook.com/TonyJonesShow. On the almighty Twitter, at Tony Jones NRI. I ask you humbly to check out rifreeradio.org, where you can hear new music from the two bands that I just played and music from this next artist, which we like to do here is take a complete juxtaposition and go to a genre, a format, a style, which is unlike all of the music you've just heard. So we're going to hear two from Meaghan Casey up next for you, starting off with Roots right here on the Tony Jones Show.
There's a secret to the road you face every day. Some say it's fiction, so it's a game you play. But then, sail our lines, I make myself a place to stay. Yeah, I'm the teeth that rip trees from roots, and I'm the soil on your foot. Never come. We'll be riding.
two from Meaghan Casey right here on the Tony Jones Show. Roots, the track I brought you into the last time we chatted. Then Sea Monsters, the one you just heard. The music continues now with a little bit from the Rhythm Coffin. This one, My Baby Digs Me. You heard it here on the Tony Jones Show.
I wanna be too.
As I get a little bit older, and as we all get a little bit older, our drugs of choice change, and I fit into that category myself. My drug of choice these days is caffeine. Now, I want to turn you on to this website slash app. Tony Jones here. You were tuned into the Tony Jones Show. CaffeineInformer.com/death-by-caffeine, where you can find out just how much caffeine would kill you. Now, some of these I can get behind. So I entered the drink. I entered my weight, which shall remain nameless. And I entered in Red Bull. Now, my maximum is 11 cans per day and 298.6 cans of Red Bull would kill me. Fine, cool, sure, that makes sense. And makes complete and absolute sense that if I were to consume close to 300 cans of Red Bull, I would, in fact, immediately expire. However, when I type in Dunkin' Donuts iced coffee, I add my weight, which shall remain nameless. The lethal dose for a Dunkin' Donuts iced coffee is 80.4 cups. However, my maximum amount for the day is 3.2 cups, and I got to say, I can get to, you know, during the busy season, 3 or 4 cups of Dunkin' Donuts iced coffee. So, Dunkin' Donuts iced coffee. So, as I tuned into this app to simply kind of have a good time as a friend and I were talking, I did actually learn real information that maybe I should cut back on the caffeine drinks just a little bit. Let me tell you what you heard. Last time we chatted, I brought you into the rhythm Coffin, My Baby Digs Me, the name of that one. Incidentally, what you'll be doing if I drink 80.4 cups of Dunkin' Donuts iced coffee. And then we just heard from Spider Cider, One or Two, the name of that one. Up next, we're going to have a double shot of the Smithereens right here on the Tony Jones Show, kicking off with Alone at Midnight.
We'll be right back.
One of the best bass lines in rock and roll history right there, and that's not hyperbole. The Smithereens, Blood and Roses, the name of that one. Coming out of two from the Smithereens, last time we chatted, I brought you into Alone at Midnight. And as I look at the clock, that means we are just about out of time for this week's Tony Jones Show. I want to thank you for tuning in and hanging out with me. Be sure to keep that new music coming in. Go to TonyJones.org or RIFreeRadio.org. Click on the contact page. We do have some great in-studio guests in the upcoming weeks. And the new music continues to be in the physical mailbox here in the studio and the inbox online. Keep all the great music coming, as I just said. Click on the contact page. And if you'd like to be in studio, that's also how you get a hold of us. We, of course, have time for one more track. We're going to leave here with a little sweet release. And as I look more closely, this is the radio edit, which I am very thankful for. It's Whether or Not. You heard it here on the Tony Jones Show. Bye, everybody. Bye.
devil.